Hi folks, John Kitz here, playing Animallica. I am a senior gamer making content for other seniors, and even if you don't qualify to be a senior, then you might want to hang out. It's a safe place to be. If you like any parts of this video or any of the other ones, please hit the likes up. Thumbs up button. And if you want to show support for the channel, hit the subscribe button. So here I am, or here we are, still on home or nouveau base. And in the last video, I think it was, or maybe the one before that, we looted that particular house over there. I think it was the one before last. And so there it is there. And now we're going to swim over to that there island and see what we can find over there. Before we go, we better take some water and some food. Okay, so let's get into the weapon mode. I don't know what that is. I wonder if that is anything. Just something sticking out there. Well, we'll swim by and see what it is. It's just something sticking out. A former tree. Or, no, it looked like it may have been a ladder of some kind. Maybe there was a wharf or something here. Anyway, we are taking a little swim. It's very easy to forget about doing these little islands off on the side of the larger islands. Quite often you end up being surprised at what you can find out here. So in this case, hopefully we will find something. Okay, back weapon in hand. Starting to get a little bit late in the day, but we will see. Hopefully we will see. Don't see anything so far. In fact, there's another little island over there. What's that down there? Just a stone. Don't see anything so far. Well, after all my advice about checking out these islands, this particular one doesn't seem to want to produce anything for us as it gradually gets darker. So we'll pick up what we can. I'll show you when we get back the storage units that I built, and can't remember how much we built it for. We just started, I think. It's kind of a strangely green water. Okay, let's take our rest right here. Seems to be a lot easier to set these things. You probably wouldn't have seen this before. When I put down a sleeping bag, quite often it wouldn't turn blue. But for some reason it seems to be working quite well today. So anyway, press F, and 12 hours away. Oh hold down the E to pick it up, and the green doesn't look so bad anymore. Well, as I say, you know, check out these little islands off the other islands, and you might be surprised to discover that it was a total waste of time. A nice green. And I'm going to have to eat and drink again, because we took some time to sleep. Ah, this is the end of the world. I never saw that before. Oh, yes, I did. In another life. Well, anyway, we've come to the end of the world. Hope you enjoyed it. Seems like a pretty nice place. The restaurant at the end of the world. If there are any Douglas Adams fans, alright, let's stop and have some drink and some food. And we get to swim back again. Not worth going over there to get that stuff. Pick the stuff up as we go. Just in case you haven't noticed. The thing with the lungs there on the upper right hand is your stamina. If you're walking, it will slowly recover. If you stop walking, it starts to recover probably about twice as quickly. Just another little tip, like not forgetting to go to these little islands. Well, that was disappointing. Okay, we came from over here. Sometimes there's, seaweed, and you can swim faster. And it seems to me, I'm not sure about this, maybe thinking of another game, that just the act of swimming took up stamina, but it doesn't anymore at this game anyway. Which is a good thing. Allows you to swim out to sea and find the end of the world. Okay, what we're going to do is what we have done in the past, is pick up some tomatoes for lunch. Rather than have a video of me walking around, come on, pick up, walking around and seeing the pretty sights, I will either put a cut in the video or do a fast forward, and when something happens of importance or interest, I will bring you all back. Oh, look, there's another little island off the main island. Let's go up there and see if we find anything interesting, because you usually do when you go out in one of those big islands. You always find something interesting. Anyway, BRB, be right back. Okay, here we are. There's a little house up ahead of us. And there's looks like a mutated cat of some kind, plus a mutated human being. We just pick up these odds and ends here, because there's some stuff that we could use. Now, cat usually only takes two shots unless you get a headshot right from the start, and then it's only one. And we are down to 27 arrows, which hopefully we can fix. Okay, two arrows it was. And we'll move in and get the arrows back if we can. One arrow at least, and I don't see a spawner, so this is not related to a spawner. So let's loot it while we can. And we take this fellow here, who is carrying a crowbar, and he's usually not very dangerous. Okay, arrows. I think I missed once. No, it took four arrows. Okay. I wonder if the location of the body makes a difference with this game, as far as where you hit with the arrow. That's a gore hound, right? Or is that a hellhound? Either way, let's see what happens. No, because if I want to give him a straight line to me, because that way he'll run straight for me. Whereas if I ducked around behind the house and took a shot, he probably would have run in a weird direction and I wouldn't have been able to get a good shot. But now I have him down. And I do not see any more arrows. So now we're down to 24 arrows. Hopefully we will find some, yeah, those plants must be dead or something, because there's nothing there. Some bird nest to make, to get feathers and then make more arrows. Because that's why I carry at all times the metal shard and the sticks. So when I get feathers, I can just pick them up. Okay, don't see anything else. Let's take a run around the back, see if there's anything here to pick up. Don't see it. We have some nice apple trees. Can't pick the apples, unfortunately. Could do with an apple right now. Okay. Another hot spot taken care of. And what I'm going to do is go a little further here and then go on a be right back method, and I'll go explore the island, and if I see anything I'll wake you guys up and we will deal with it. So be right back. Okay, here we are back at the little island off the island, and I just want to show you guys that when you pick up this particular kind of thing, there's a couple of these around to pick up, and I can't remember what they're used for, but here they are, and I press E and hold it, and I picked it up, and it made a nice little sound. So until the next exciting thing happens, I'll be right back. Okay, nothing hugely exciting here. There's a lynx or a bobcat of some kind. As far as I know, doesn't seem particularly interested in me. I don't know if it would attack or not, but until I get a lot of cure potions and tame potions built up, I'm not going to collect things. I'm going to wait till everything's cleared away and then go back and start curing animals as we find them. Now, that's the other thing over there. I still haven't figured out what this thing is all about. Because as you get close to it, you hear the thunder, and that happens. But you get here, and I have previously tried the flamethrower on it, and tried to beat the heck out of it. Nothing happens, just does that. And then if I back away, the thunder comes again, and this time it gets this thing in the middle. So I don't know what it does. I may have just triggered a spawning point. I don't know. If I have, I hope whatever spawns here can't swim. But there you go. Someday we'll come back and check that out. Or maybe somebody can tell me what that's all about. So I just left the area and I heard the thunder again, so it's turned down. I can't tell if the thingy is still on or not. Anyway, okay, we are about to swim back and move along the coast here until I see anything new. I will let you guys take a snooze and I'll just edit what I need to edit. So I'll be right back. Okay, now, for those of you who like to watch videos to see people die, in a gaming sense, I'm sure, this is where I died before on this game, and it was because, as I think I explained in a previous video, I had a crossbow with me, which I'm surprised I haven't found yet. Anyway, had a crossbow with me, and there was a longer delay than I was used to, and just threw me off completely. I think I ended up climbing up on a rock that was here or something, not this one. But it doesn't seem to have spawned here this time around. But anyway, so... And when you know, it's just starting to get dark, too, so we'll have to clean this up fairly quickly. But I have no reason to believe this one's any... scarier than normal. Except I want daylight for this, just in case it is a bit trickier. So, let us sleep our way through. First of all, let's take a drink, have a little munch before bedtime, bring this down to number 7, okay, press F, and I have to sleep the full 12 hours, still early morning, 8:02, let's sleep another hour. Pick this up. Now, I'm okay for hunger. and Thirst, and I don't see the one guy that I was most worried about. I'd rather not go over there. I want to make sure I have my distance. I don't see the damn thing. Okay, I see that one. I wonder if I can... He's a white color. Not used to that. So let's line up so he comes straight at me. Across this area here. Oh, there's the other guy there. I'd rather take him out first. Get my nerve up. See, that wasn't hard. Now, how many arrows? 21. He's a smart guy. He's hiding behind a tree. Where is he? See, that wasn't too hard. Sorry to disappoint you, but I didn't die. But the tension was just unbearable. Anyway, arrow. Come on, give me some more arrows. That's a different color, so that was a specific kind. Now, if I loot him, I'm gonna leave him there till I take care of what looks like a spawner over there. Making sure. How many arrows? 16. I'm getting down there. A little bit worried here. Because without arrows, it means I've got to step right up with an axe and start slugging it out. Okay, now this is what's this one called? A lightning essence. It wasn't a spawner at all. Alright, so much the better. Now, where was this guy? Zebra-colored fellow. And let's see if it says he's somehow unique. That is a hellhound. Okay, we know that. And this guy is a gorehound. Alright. Just basic old hellhound. Okay. Well, here we go again, for a little bit longer, like I know that going this way, I don't know actually, pretty sure that going this way there's nothing of interest. It's a few deer. So there is a house somewhere over the hill here. And what I will do after I hoppy hop up to the top of this hill, take a long view here. Don't see anything. Oh look, little islands up there. You know, you really should go up there and check those out. Hoppity 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 hoppity. I've got a rabbit here. As we reach the top, get a bigger view of the island. over there. In case I haven't pointed this out before, if you look on the upper left on the radar there, you see where the balloon is. That's always your way of orientating yourself. And it also will show where your horse is, assuming you have one. Okay, so I will let you guys snooze for a bit, and I'll be right back when something of importance. Okay, here we are back, and just to close off this particular video, we're going to take care of four hounds of some kind. What are those? Gore hounds, I think. And is that a hell hound, or is it a different color gore hound? I forget how we're supposed to distinguish one from t'other. Maybe one's just a baby that we're going to kill. Okay, are we ready? Let us take it. Is that strike with the other one? I get those arrows because I only have 12 left. I don't see a damn arrow. Yikes. Do I have any feathers? Did I? Nope. So, 12 arrows, 4 beasts of burden here. Don't waste any. So 10 arrows, 2 beasts. One is hidden over behind there, but we can take care of this guy. Good, got all 4 arrows back. Now, where'd that other guy go? Do not like surprises. He's probably sitting right on that other side of that knoll, and I'm going to walk right into him. No, I'm not. I'm going to come over this way, pick up the marigold, and there he is there. Okay, that took 5 arrows, didn't it? Or did I miscount? Got 4 back anyway. Anymore, so let's take care of the spawner. Okay. So I got 9 arrows. Take care of our next piece of business. Okay, let's clean these guys up while we're here. That there's a house off to our left, or our right, rather. And there's another one of those weird statue spawner-looking kind of things. That thing there. Once again, no idea what this does. I'm sure if I went to the discussion page on Steam, I would find out. But this is the exciting part, as the thunder rolls. So here we are. This one's green. I back away. Thunder again. Only this time, okay, unless I come closer, maybe if I go closer again, it'll, that thing will happen. But let's just not go back in there this time. See if that makes a difference. That never happened before. Okay, now we've got to take care of this little house over here. And I think, if I remember from before, there are some nasties here. If I can get some height. Yeah, there we go. Three, at least. And as they run towards me, they'll disappear behind that knoll. Excuse me. So now I can't see them. Okay, I can see one guy there. Disappeared in the leaves, and there he is, kind of walking through here. He's the guy with the chainsaw, right? So I have three arrows left. Six back. And I don't think there's a spawner there, so let's take these guys out as we go. So nine arrows to take out two more of our little friends. Say hello to my little friend. Oops, I missed that one. Thanks. Some damage there. Wasted some arrows. There's another one there. Four arrows back. Down to seven. Okay, let's eat some food. That'll bring my health back up. Might as well drink while we're here. Okay, we got one more to go, I think. Where is he? Gonna come running out of nowhere? Around. There's either two of them or one fast one. Okay, where did he go? There he is. Ah, come on. Thanks. Ran out of arrows. now I'm in a situation because, well, number one, there still could be another one around here. And number two, I've got to go other places and I need arrows. And it'd be nice if I went in there and found a bunch of arrows. Okay, I don't see anybody else here. Okay, now, what do we get here? Food. Seeds. I can cook. Pick up some more hide, get a hammer, get a toolbox. And that's it. No arrows. Not even some feathers. Bolts and nails. Ding dang, dang da da ding dang dang. Okay, that's the coastline there that goes back toward the base. So, okay, this video is going to get pretty long here, so let's say sayonara. And when we come back, one of two things. Either we'll go to Corpse Harbor, where there are vendors, and buy some feathers. Or maybe if I'm lucky, when I walk along the coast, I'll see some birds' nests. But until then, thanks for watching the video, and if you liked any part thereof, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you want to show support for the channel, please hit the subscribe button. So until next time, please do take care.